So Cheryl, we're like, what, 3-4 wineries in right now? What's the highlight so far?
Definitely Villacana.
Why?
That Zinfandel combo raspberry and pepper, yum. And the Pinot there was amazing.
Off the top of the car?
Off the top of the car.
Alright, where are we headed next?
Adelaida.
Whose favorite winery is that?
Melissa Clark. Or is it yours?
No, not really. I think it's Alyssa England's favorite winery, actually.
Alyssa's.
But long time no hear from her.
No,
we know.
I thought you mentioned Melissa liked it. Yeah.
Yeah, nobody cares.
Take? Or am I? Oh, I'm probably on movie. Hold on.
Yeah. When you talk about a fire pit, yeah. That's a fire pit. Let's get up close and personal with the next stage fire pit. That's what I'm talking about. So this is what $110 gets you these days. Motel 6. A Tuscadero. This is tremendous stuff right here, people. $110, 56 cents. The 56 cents looks what it gets you here. It gets you some pretty kick-ass comforters and a special smell in the room. This is a pretty good view from our front door of the Motel 6 in Tuscadero. Woohoo! Oh, you hear that up there? Yeah, that's the 101 freeway that's right behind these couple of rows of trees. Good stuff. Hey, and look at the little cats. They're playing. They're going into the sewer. So we're here at the fun place. Remember that guy's? Tobin James. Headed over to Kamea next. Very loud. There was a little bachelorette party action going on in the inside. Cheryl was quite enthralled by the lovely ladies that were in there. Me? I don't care. So this is what you rent if you're trying to get into a whole bunch of trouble. It's called the Central Coast Trolley Company. We'll have more on that in a couple of minutes when we go inside of Bianchi's winery. That's coming up next. Give me fuel, give me fire, give me that which I desire. Dude, I can't even keep the camera straight. I'm like,
I haven't seen so many matching shoes.
Since when does Julie have style?
Oh, she has lots of shoes.
Sometimes you just need a little help when the itch is on the back of your neck. So this is what happens when you're a winery dog. You just get yourself up on the table and you clean up after the people that left their scraps earlier in the day. It's good times. It's good stuff. He's having a good time. We're here at an olive farm in Paso Robles off of Adelaida Road. Fantastic stuff here. Couple of different kinds of extra virgin California olive oil, and they also make a Kalamata extra virgin olive oil, which was great. It's beautiful, beautiful facility here. We'll pan over and take a look at what's going on up here up in the hills. Lots of olive trees and other walnut trees in this area. Absolutely stunning. Great stuff. So here we are. We're at the end of day two. No bachelorette parties. Just us and dinner. Not dinner, but dinner. They tell us this is the best. We'll see what happens. We'll be back with you in a second. So here we are, we're at day three, and Mecca, one may say, the beaver winery. Because that's what Costoro means in Italian, everybody. Beaver cellars.
Does the damn fine wine.
And look at John Scott taking pictures in the background. It's good stuff. Something terrible happened here 3 years ago, right in this very spot. A case of delicious Tempranillo from Costoro Cellars was dropped. Many bottles were lost right at this spot, very close to where that very red garbage can is at. Right here at Tablas Creek, we lost a case of Tempranillo.